Hello guys, welcome to the .NET office, and this is our second video of C++ tutorial series. In the last video we just discussed about the basic introduction of C++, so but from this video we will talk about the OOS concept. So these are the objective for this video, and first is, what is OOPS? So using OOPS, or we say object oriented programming, we can design and develop a program using modular approach. Modular approach is nothing but create your program in modules, I mean in the small programs, so that in the last we can integrate them and we can create our complete program or complete solutions. So that's the thing. And using object oriented programming, we can create and develop a real-time application as well. And basically this OOPS actually is a data centric, actually it's focused on data rather than functions. So using this data and function, we can operate on these data. So that's the actual concept of the OOPS. So it's mostly focused on data. So these are the difference between the object oriented programming and procedural oriented programming. So first is like, yeah, of course, object oriented programming is a object oriented, whereas this procedural oriented programming is structural oriented. When we say object oriented, it means program basically focus on objects rather than functions or other things. Whereas in procedural, when you talk about the structural oriented, it means the program mostly focus on data structure, or we can say subroutines. So that's the thing. And second is like, in the OOPS, we divide our programs into objects. And in the procedural, we divide our programs into functions, and that's how the functionality works in the procedural. So in the object oriented programming, we use the bottom up approach, and procedural we use the top down approach, like we discussed in our last video as well. Bottom approach is nothing but first we create our small programs, then we integrate all those programs and we reach to the solutions. But in the procedural oriented programming, first we created complex program, then we break them into the smaller programs, and that's how it works into the top-down approach. And in object oriented programming, we use inheritance. But in procedural oriented programming, we does not use inheritance. Inheritance is nothing but using the properties or data of the other functions. We will discuss brief about these inheritance in our later videos. So what and next is, object oriented program use access specifier, but procedural does not use any access specifier. Access specifier is nothing but it makes your program more secure. Like in our C++, we use a public, protected, private. These are the access specifier we use in our C++. And yeah, this we will discuss as well in our video. And second thing, next is encapsulation we use in our object oriented programming. But in procedural, we don't use encapsulation. Encapsulation is nothing but binding the data and functions together. Like for example, in class, in C++, we use classes, and in the classes, we use our data and function together, so that outside world cannot use those things. And yeah, next is like, object oriented programming use the virtual functions as well. In procedural, we don't use virtual functions. So it's a very good concept, this virtual function in object oriented programming, which we'll discuss in our later video. These object oriented programming basically use in C++, Java, Python, whereas it's procedural oriented programming use in C, Pascal. These are the languages where we use procedural oriented programming. So, and these are the concepts which we use in OOPS, and which makes our programs more secure, more flexible. So yeah, so these are the things which will all these topics we will discuss in brief in our later videos. So this is it. Thank you guys for watching this video. Please let us know your feedback through your comments, and please subscribe our channel as well. Thank you.